Welcome to doafco.com. So this is the second lecture of our series. So in this lecture we are going to talk about what is an intra. So I said second because in embedded C series this is the second lecture where we are going to talk about what is an intra. So before talking about interrupt, as you have seen in my first lecture, if not seen, I'll put the link in the description box, that how to program an Arduino as an AVR board and how to program it using embedded C. So there I have told you about the things like how you can set the port and what is a DDR, what is data direction register, that means. And I've also told you that if you put the whole thing in while one, then you can keep blinking the LED forever, that is in an infinite loop or a super loop. So what is an interrupt? So basically all our embedded programs are like they run inside a super loop, that is they always do the same thing. So like your some machine, like take the example of any embedded machine, like your RO. So the regular work of your RO is to separate the water, I mean clean the water by doing reverse osmosis process. But suddenly it gets the interrupt from the sensor that the water tank is full. That is the container is full where we need to collect the water. So it will jump from that regular processing to stop the reverse osmosis so that water don't come out of that tank because it is already full. So this is like an interrupt. So as you can see, I've written interrupt is a signal. Interrupt is a signal to processor emitted by hardware or software indicating that an event need immediate attention. So like in that case of RO, that water getting filled up is a immediate action, is a interrupt that required immediate action by the processor. So processor have to stop doing the regular work that it is doing and give extra attention to the interrupt. So if you have seen my first video, that I have programmed the blinking LED. So normally think of a small machine that you have created. So the normal function of that machine is to blink the LED. But if somebody press some switch or button, then the LED should stop blinking. So that switch is an interrupt for us, and in this case this is a hardware interrupt. So interrupts can be of two types, a software interrupt or a hardware interrupt. As I've already told you, a hardware interrupt is like a switch or something initiated by an external peripheral like button, some mic or anything. So a software interrupt is like an internal thing happening. So like processor is doing something and some situation came, like an exception came that should not come. So it is in software interrupt. So interrupts are can be handled in two way. So the first way is to handle them is by using polling. So polling is in form of sequential coding only. So it's like your program, instead of doing some regular task, is kept on waiting to see some interrupt is coming or not. Like your program doesn't blink, rather than that it kept on waiting for whether the switch would be pressed or not, whether the switch would be pressed or not. So polling take extra time because you need to keep an eye on the continuous motion, a continuous thing that is happening. So instead of polling, that comes the second way of doing things, that is an interrupt. So for interrupt, you need to have a interrupt service routine. So it's a special function, we can say in normal language. So it's a special function that when an interrupt come should be executed. So like interrupt came, the sensor give the interrupt that the button is pressed. So interrupt service routine is that method only. So like if you get the input from the sensor that the water tank is full, so that sudden interrupt came, that it is in form of hardware interrupt, so it came, and the action that need to be taken is written in an ISR. So the action would be to stop filtering things, water. So that is our interrupt service routine. So in a bigger program or a bigger software stack, there are various interrupt and there would be various interrupt service routine. So for that, they have these special memory locations, and you can get these memory locations about interrupt service routine from interrupt vector table. So in our AVR, that is our ATmega328P, we have various interrupts. So this is the table that you can find in the data sheet. So it's like it tells you the vector table and the priority of various interrupts. So there are few interrupts that are maskable, few interrupts that are non-maskable. So maskable interrupt means if they are not important, you can mask them. You don't want them to do anything, so you will mask them. But some interrupts you cannot mask, like a reset button. If you press the reset button, then the system has to reset. So this reset is given the highest priority, as you can see in the table, that is vector number 1. So after that, it has two external interrupts that you can use for external peripherals, and it has two pin change interrupts. They can also be used for external interrupts. Both are interrupts only, but the way they work is different. Like I'll tell you about them in the next video when we will talk how to program an interrupt. So after that, there are various interrupt, like timer interrupt. You have put some timer, and whenever the timer get complete, there's interrupt will come. So these are like software interrupts. So then you have overflow interrupts, and then you have interrupts from various communication protocols. So this is all for this lecture, and if you want to read this chapter on the data sheet, then you can go to chapter 11 of data sheet. That is, if you can see here, so I'll put the link of data sheet in the description box, and here you can find the chapter 11. So here you can see the interrupt table, and everything about interrupt is written here, and about external interrupt and pin change interrupt also. So that's all for this lecture, and for next lecture, please stay tuned, and please like, share and subscribe my channel.